All right, there we go. Well, you're doing right. You're drinking alcohol. That kills germs, right? Hold on. My speakers are...
Oh, yeah. I meant to ask. When you hear this, is it really shrill?
What? No.
It's not shrill.
Okay, and then when it goes off?
Well, I gotta get up.
No, but is it really, really shrill?
No, it's not bad. Okay, good.
Oh, yeah, I just want to make sure that when it comes through that it's not deafening anyone.
All right, well, let's see. All right. So, test, 1, 2. Say something.
Yo, what up?
Yo, all right. Hey.
All right, just making sure. I updated our broadcasting software tonight. Of course, it always decides to update on the nights that we decide to do this, but...
We pick patch day, apparently.
Alright, so it is... Alright, so everything should be coming through, and my correct audio setup...
You need to remember to move
to
the middle.
Well, yeah, so we're all in the middle now. So, alright, so we're here, we're live... I am going to actually. You know what I'm going to do? I am going to move
you
the chat room. I'm going to put the chat room over Ray's head on my screen, so I have more room.
Oh, for Ray.
Ray will be
fine.
I'll
put my head on him.
Ray will be fine. All right. So tonight, not a regular show. We're going to play some games. Specifically, a game called Mangaka, and we have. Z and I, we both backed, we supported, it's awesome, and we have its creator, Jason.
Hello.
You can find him on Mockman on Twitter. He's back. This is the first time Ray gets to meet him. Ray was disappointed last time we had you on.
Yes. He's one of the guests that I have a lot more in common with.
Because of our deep shared love of anime and manga, that's what you mean.
Oh, God.
Pretty much, yes. He gets upset when he's like... When was it? Attack on Titan? You've been trying to get Zia to watch forever.
That
she refuses.
Yeah. And I struggle on a weekly basis to not start watching Code Geass again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's my jam right there.
That's your cross to bear.
I know.
All right. So tonight we are going to play Mangaka with its creator. And we're pretty excited. In fact, we also have our lovely Zia. She will be drawing her comics up on a whiteboard. Look at that. We got a whiteboard for this. That's how you know we went high tech here. And so, yeah, this could get weird. But it'll be fun.
It's going to get weird, dude.
Well, of course it'll get weird. Let's just be honest. It's going to get weird.
It'll be fun.
I mean... When I played this with my wife, she drew an amputee who wanted to be a comedian and went to a fortune teller, and the fortune teller wound up getting him attacked by vampires. So, and she felt bad for him, so then she carried him around on her back, and that was the end of her story. It was very weird, but it was hilarious.
Well, thank you so much for having me on. Basically, this is the game... I mean, if I put it in one sentence, it's like Pictionary for comics, right? But it's not about drawing ability so much as it's about your creativity and also your speed and how much you're willing to work the system to win. Because it's not a judge game, you know. I didn't want it to be a game where it's like, oh, who's the awesome got the awesomest story, and then everyone's like, oh, that story is about, you know. So we tried to make it something more, a little different, and you guys who've played it, you know what it's like, and I guess everyone else will find out soon.
Yes.
Yeah.
Super excited for this.
All right. So Jason, before we get started, why don't you kind of cover some of the rules for the game?
All right. Okay, so basically, so Mangaka. So, essentially, this is the game in which you become a manga artist, striving for fame. Your goal is to become the most famous mangaka, which is, of course, represented by fame points. And the game actually begins with everyone drawing three theme cards. That is the fame. Dave has the fame. He brings the fame, and I bring the theme. So basically, in my high-tech method called printing out the rules and putting them in front of the screen, you can see this is what you're going to start out with. You're going to start out by drawing three red cards. And I too, am going to draw three red cards since I'm playing with you. And now each of us must come, these cards become our obsessions. This is what we are obsessed with as an artist. And so we must try to come up with a story which involves these three cards.
All right, so I got my.
Can someone draw me some cards? Or
yes.
I got
three cards for you coming up, Roy.
All three of your obsessions cannot be birds. It cannot be birds.
Oh, thank God! Thank God, none of it's birds. I got it. I got your cards right here, buddy.
Okay.
All right. So I got my cards, and I got Ray's cards.
And I guess Ray will need to know what his cards are. So we may as well all reveal what our cards are now. All
right. So we'll do Ray's first, since I have his. So his first one up. You know what? I'm gonna switch to, right now. Here we go. All right, so Ray, your first card is greed or the desire for money.
Yes.
Okay.
And then you also got religion, which greed and religion seem to go really well, especially if you are a struggling Catholic, and that works, and or doctors and surgeons.
So
greed, religion, and doctors.
Nice.
That's Ray.
Okay.
All right, and since I'm up here, so mine are disasters or apocalypses.
Oh.
Guns and swords.
I feel like your rolls are really, really good to go together.
Got like every anime and
yeah.
All right.
It's just how it is.
All right, so let's go, Jason. Why don't we do yours next?
Okay, mine are mine are archaeology.
Ooh.
Okay.
Also food or cooking.
Ooh.
And lastly, mathematics. So
ooh.
Combine these three into a story.
That's gonna be interesting.
You could find fossilized food and then count them.
All right. Here we go. Weird hairstyles. Theater acting, desserts or sweets.
I like how you get like desserts or sweets. That was very Steven Seagal-ish.
Exciting things.
Okay, so what happens next? Well, all right. Basically, there's three basic rules in the game, and basically each round you have 5 minutes to do a comic. And so we've got these sheets, which are now blank. Except for Heather, who will have to do the extra labor of drawing her own comic panels on the blackboard, like we used to do in early playtests. But basically, every round you have 5 minutes to do a page, and the game is four rounds, and so at the end of the game, you have a four-page comic. But how do you score these comics? How does it become a game? Well, this is basically how it works. All right, the first rule is that you have to express your three red cards. You have to express your themes. And how do you do that? Well, it's not like Pictionary, where, say, if you get, like, the subject World War II, you have to express that without using any text. No, it's a comic. You can, for instance, if your theme is robots, you can either draw a big robot, or you can just have some people saying the word robots. Either is completely valid. It's completely valid. And so you get one fame point for each of your cards that you're able to put in that round. Okay, next thing is you gotta draw something in each panel. So you have, say, in the first round you have two panels, you have to draw something that is like a recognizable thing in each panel. Now, it doesn't have to be complicated. It could just be like a smiley face, or the moon, or a stick figure. But it has to be something. It can't just be words. It can't just be like a sound effect. And it can't just be like a little scribble. But if you include some words for context, like, oh, that scribble is actually a blood stain, then it's fine. It's completely fine. Okay, and if you draw something in each panel, you get 2 more fame. All right. Now the third rule, and the trickiest rule, is, of course, it's a comic, so you can use words. But if your comic is too long, your readers will abandon you. You'll be too boring. So if your comic has too many words, you'll lose fame points. So for that reason, you can only have 3 word balloons per round for maximum fame.
Ooh.
And a word balloon in this case counts as anything that's not a noise. For instance, it includes signs. So for instance, if someone is punching somebody and it says pow, and that's fine, it's a sound effect. You can use as many sound effects as you want. But if someone is in a prisoner of war camp and a sign says POW or POW, that's a word balloon. Okay. So anything that's like a noise, you can use it. That's a sound effect and that's free. So you can have as much like pow, 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 ba, 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 bam, fap, 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 or whatever you want.
Question.
Yes.
All right, because this came up when my wife and I were playing. What about screams? Do screams count as sounds or as word balloons?
Well, there's a lot of questions like this which are up to us as the audience, as the players, because when we play, we're going to take turns drawing and then judging each other, you know, just like in normal society. Okay. we will play, we will judge each other and become the audience of the comic. But I would say that a scream is a sound effect and doesn't count as a word balloon. Unless, right. Of course, it's a scream of like, unless a scream means something, like they're screaming, tomato, you know, I mean, that would be a word balloon. But if it's just like, ah, then yeah. I would say that as a sound effect.
That's okay, all right. I let my wife have that as a sound effect, and it probably saved our marriage.
I would say that you, you chose wisely.
I think so too.
If only we had the creator of the game here to ask.
Yeah, exactly.
We were playtesting this game for like 5 years, so it's been through many, many iterations. But yes, I would say that a scream is a sound effect.
All right. It's good to know.
And so if you have 3 or less word balloons, you get an extra 2 points. And that's good. That's good news.
I can do that.
So that's your basic rules for each round. 1, include your themes. 2, fill every panel with some kind of drawing. And 3, don't get too wordy. And that's 3 word balloons per page, not per panel, basically. So. Okay, so basically now is the point at which I assume you've all come up with an awesome story idea involving your themes, and now you can take a moment to draw your to write a title for your manga, or the a pin name perhaps if you want to go under an alias because you don't want your family to know that you did this manga. And
what is that, Ray?
Well, it says I'm fancy.
Oh,
I wanted to see how I'm gonna hold this up, so I'm just testing.
I think my pen name is gonna be Bacon King. I'm gonna go with that.
Okay.
All right. I got my title. I'm good. I think I'm ready to go.
Okay, so here's the deal, folks. Someone needs to get a timer and time us for 5 minutes. And normally I like to play dramatic music during this 5 minutes. Of course, most of that is copyrighted, so I don't
know. Oh, you're right.
Twitch.
What about like a ringtone that's scary? I think we can get away with that. Like Bossa Nova or something like that. Like that's public domain, scary. Isn't it?
Yeah, there we go. We'll just listen to a screaming alarm. That will inspire. I like playing 80s montage music or like the Dragon Ball theme song or something, but. Yeah. But I guess we'll have to just imagine in our heads, or maybe hum dramatically. And so I guess whenever someone wants to do the timer, we can start our comic.
Okay.
And there's more that will happen starting in the second round as we introduce trend cards.
All
but
right.
That's for later.
All right, Zia, are you doing the timer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we've all agreed that it's going to be 5 minutes, right?
Yes, we're going to do 5 minutes.
Okay. I'm my body is ready. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minutes on the timer. Go.
All right,
hum dramatically.
That's not dramatic, that's like angry.
Nothing's gonna ever keep me down. You're the best around.
No one's
gonna ever keep you down. Alright.
We can do a little role play here too if you want. You've just moved to Tokyo. You don't want to have to go back to your small town in the boonies. You've got to become a manga artist. You can't disappoint your parents. Can you do it?
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Ooh. It's easy to get going and forget your theme in some ways.
I feel like I'm running out of time already.
You got a while. You got four minutes.
I got 4 minutes? Oh, okay.
Alright. Dun-dun-dun. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay.
Alright. Let's see here. I got...
Oh, if you're done early, like before the 5 minutes are up, you can just impress everybody by stopping, throwing in your pin. You know, intimidate the rest of us.
Mm.
Put fear into us. You don't get any bonus for it, but, you know, just to show how cool you are.
I wish I knew how much time is left.
Oh,
3 minutes.
Nice.
Plenty of time.
An eternity of time, almost.
Yeah.
It's 3 minutes, 2 panels, piece of cake.
Oh, it's going to get really hairy when the panels are like, they're like
yeah.
A bunch of one.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just gonna keep drawing, I guess. I'm drawing backgrounds now.
Add all that crosshatching and speed lines. Maybe some extra speed lines.
Ooh, speed.
Or kind of like flowers and stuff floating in the background if you're doing a shoujo manga. I mean, you know, it's your call.
How do I do lens flare? I don't know how to draw lens flares. I need to draw a lens flare. J.J. Abrams, eat your heart out.
All right. We got 1 minute and 40 seconds.
Oh, man.
Wait, we get that. So, do we like mic drop the pen if we're done?
Yeah, do it.
No, no, I want to keep drawing stuff. I want to keep drawing stuff.
Yeah, but my drawing is Stickman. So.
Hey, Stickman is a Christmas cartoon on Amazon Prime, by the way. My kids love it.
Hey.
So, if you're drawing Stickman, Stickman's an actual thing. Though it's an actual stick that's sort of a man, but not really. It's really weird.
Is it?
It's
one line.
No, Stickman. No, like a stick that you find like off of like a tree. It's really weird. Okay. It's one of those stop motion cartoons.
Okay. Sure. Whatever.
Yeah.
Make them happy. So. When I zoom back out, like when we're talking right now, does this look okay? In your fancy schmancy? Are you still drawing? I thought you mic dropped.
No, I'm drawing background stuff. I'm bringing more detail.
I'm still drawing too.
Adding flair. 30 seconds.
30 seconds. Flair.
Yes, sir. Flair. Add your flair. Oh, shoot.
All right. Now I think I'm done. I think if I add any too much for you, you won't be able to tell what I'm actually drawing. So, yeah.
9, 8, 7, 6.
Taking a drink.
Can't count backwards.
Taking a drink.
All right. Mm. Time's up.
All right.
Okay. So we can Rochambeau to see who goes first. Or we can determine it based on
Ray lost
to read a comic.
the last one to read a comic. The last comic I read was a while back. It was in like October. It was Deadpool.
Okay. Oof. Then you want to have last October beat.
I'm before that.
Graphic novel counts too, right?
Oh yeah, or manga or whatever.
Yeah, I read Why the first volume one of Why the Last Man in like July. I had like
400 chapters of Noblesse.
What?
It's a manga called Noblesse. I don't know how you say it though.
Huh. Okay.
So you just said it.
I don't know how you say it properly because I say things wrong.
God.
But you win then.
Right now, Jason most is just likely. Jason is just in pain.
Yeah. All right, so let's have Ray read first.
Okay.
So, all right.
Do I do it panel by panel?
Yeah. Show us your just put your comic in front of the screen. Imagine that. Okay, the new issue of Shonen Jump is out, and we, the readers, we log online or we go to our local manga store and we see this amazing story presented to us, and the story is called what?
Holy Hemophiliacs.
All right.
I forgot what the title was, so I didn't get a chance to work the title into the show yet.
It's always okay. Fun when you can put name a title drop. So read it to us.
All right. So I think it says, I need more patience now. That's the doctor saying that. And then there's this calling him Senpai, and she's just like, look. And then there's people falling to the road, apparently. So then there's a close up on the doc right there, and he's just like, thank the gods, but I need more. And he's screaming, and there's a ton of exclamation points because, you know, the scream went on for a very long time because he's talking to the gods.
Wait, I need a reminder of your themes, but please continue. Yes. I didn't mean to interrupt.
Greed, religion, and doctors.
All right, that's us. Does this comic have greed?
Yes, I need more patience.
He's greedy for patience.
Like anger about not having enough patience.
And does it have religion, everyone?
God.
It's in the title.
I don't know about that.
Thank God. No, he says thank the gods. That's
okay. I'll give.
I think that counts.
Yeah, you can be as cruel or as nice as you want when you're judging this game.
All right.
It will be returned on you when your time comes. So right, you have to know your audience. So, okay. I guess all right, we'll give so it that's to two out of three, and I guess it has doctors definitely.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And I see two word balloons in the first panel. And one in the last panel, so that's 3 points for themes, 2 points for drawing something in each panel, and 2 points for not having too many balloons. You get 7 points.
That's amazing. Good job. Game.
I messed up on mine now. Now I'm realizing how I messed up.
Okay. It's okay. You'll get a chance to catch up in future rounds. So, boom. All right. So, this lucky fellow, what's your pin name?
We were supposed to fill that out.
If you're proud of this comic, you don't need to use a pen name.
They haven't figured out who wrote it yet. Let me see here.
That's the name? That's the name. They haven't figured out who wrote it yet.
It's the name of this person. Maybe...
I know. His name is God.
Oh,
is that,
Lord.
Does that count for religion?
No!
No.
Come on!
But you already got religion in the comic anyway, so...
Yeah, you're fine.
So someone should keep track of the fame.
It's seven, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ray's got seven.
I'll keep track of his fame.
Okay.
Heather,
maybe
you could do it in the corner of your whiteboard somewhere? Like on the lower corner?
Yeah.
Someplace where you're not drawing anything.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ultimately, I could do it on a piece of paper.
Here for now. We'll be fine. Okay, so Ray...
No... Yeah, I feel like you just lost a whole lot of real estate there.
Okay.
I'll keep track on the back of my first sheet. All right, I got it.
Can I just keep track by putting down I got 7 points on that one?
Maybe. Well, we don't trust you in your terrible math skills.
All right. My pen name, by the way.
Okay.
I just talked with the gods, and they told me his name, my name is Fushinji Tatanka.
I'm never gonna remember. I'm just gonna. Right. On the score sheet, I'm just gonna call you Ray. How about that?
Well, I didn't know if we were supposed to.
That's fine. You could go Fushingi, whatever.
Fushingi. So now the next question to read would be, we actually would go clockwise. So I don't know how that would work. Is that even doable?
I don't know. How about Heather, you go next?
It would be you, Jason.
Well, how about we go based on how easy it is for me to do the overlay? So we're going to do... So are we're going
to
go...
I need to go up a tick, don't I?
Yeah, right there. You're good. Ooh. Right there.
Okay.
Awesome. All right.
So mine says... So just a reminder, my themes were desserts or sweets, theater or acting, and weird hairstyles. So here we have... the name of this is The Taming of the Stomach. And he is saying to eat or not to eat. And he has some Sonic the Hedgehog hair going on here. And there's this cake. Tasty treat. Which I use too many word bubbles now. I'm realizing this. But tasty treat. And then over here, he says to eat or not to eat, dot, dot, dot. No question, eat. And he gulps down his cake.
Well, it's a sound effect, so...
Oh, a gulp counts as a sound effect?
I feel like gulp is a sound effect.
Unless you're referring to, like, Mr. Gulp or something like that. I would...
No, it's like gulp.
Sounds like a sound effect to me.
It sounds like a sound effect. We'll give it to you this time. This time! This time!
This time! All right, cool.
What's the title of your manga? Does it have a title, or is it untitled?
Yeah, The Taming of the Stomach.
Oh, right, yeah. Okay.
And all right. My pen name is... Oh, I'm sorry. Please continue.
No. Continue. You continue, please. What's
okay.
Your pen?
I just want to say my pen name is Fushroga.
Nice. A lot of fush going on here.
Well, because I was trying to go with the fush.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
So does this comic have what are your themes? Does it have theater and acting?
Desserts or sweets? Yes, theater, acting. Stage. Yeah.
And does it have weird hairstyles?
It certainly looks like it.
If anyone feels this comic should not receive all three theme points, let them speak now. Whoever hold their peace.
Oh, I thought you were going to say I shouldn't get it. I was like, that's cake!
No, it seems legit to me. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
That's a pretty flat looking cake.
Hey. It's pumpkin pie.
That is not cake, then!
No, I'm just kidding. It's a dessert. Dessert or sweet. Doesn't matter.
It's a vegetable.
Nice try.
Doesn't matter how it looks. It's about the intention.
Okay. All right.
Aha!
So, she gets 7 points?
Yes, 7 points!
All right.
It's neck and neck.
All right, Jason, you are next.
All right, so mine is called Babel Burger by Asher Bonapal Joe.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful.
All right. At last, I found the ancient... hold on, I can't read my own writing backwards. I found the recipes for the Babylonian kings. Now my dream of opening a chain of Babylonian restaurants can come true. Sir, your expenses far exceed revenue. You're losing money at a rate of $100,000 a month. Okay. All right. Well, so my themes were archaeology.
Babylonia.
All right. Food or cooking.
Yep.
And mathematics.
There's definitely math in there.
Yes. There's definitely math. I feel it. I feel it works. I feel like you got everything.
Yeah, beautiful 5-minute comic.
That is awesome. Like compared to ours, which is just gutter trash.
What? No. Oh, we can all. The race is still wide open. We're all tied.
Yeah, but now I saw how well you can draw, and it's defeating.
Well, you should let that anger burn inside you, and you can.
I gotta switch one of my.
It's bringing up all the religion I need to bust out in my next piece.
Yeah, it is my turn. I just need to. Apparently, my video settings changed midway through here, so.
Okay.
All right. For some reason, it is... So anyway, so my themes were swords, disasters or apocalypses, and guns. So, my thing is called Armageddon Out of Here. That counts, right? All right.
As a what? As a like point off? Yes,
so,
it counts as a point off.
So here's my dude. As you can see, he's got a sword, and he's got a gun, and there's a nuclear explosion going on in the background. See, there, and then there is
my... Are you sure? It looks like broccoli.
Look, have you ever seen broccoli that big? That is the apocalypse. Yes. All right. Yes. All right. And look, lens flare right there on the sword.
Oh, come on.
And then not only do we have an explosion, but we got mutant zombies. So here's a regular zombie, and then here's like a really weird zombie that looks like he's from the Goonies.
Close up. I want to see mutant zombies. Yeah, that is totally
look
mutant.
Look at that.
And there's burning buildings, just in case. And they want brains. So there you go.
So you actually have all your themes in the first panel, and the rest is just to show off how awesome it is.
Yeah.
I have to take another one. Definitely a winner.
All right,
so...
I like to say he deserves 20. No points.
Shut up, Ray.
It looks like we're all tied. And that means... Typically, when we were playing games in the playtest with little kids, we would let the tie go to the youngest kid. But since we are all of responsible age, I think we should Rochambeau to see who breaks the tie.
You don't want to hit people the nuts.
Yeah, I feel like Zia automatically wins all Rochambeau championships here.
Yeah. However, you guys want
to.
If you have
you have no nuts. Rochambeau's getting kicked in the nuts.
Oh, that's what that means?
Yes! Getting kicked in the nuts until, like, you're the last one standing. You have no nuts, so...
Wasn't it from South Park, I think?
Yes! The Rochambeau World Championships.
Let's do it. Let's send each other a virtual nut kick. I'm sure that's possible.
Well, Zia won. Oh, right. My nuts!
Her. Okay, so can I go to Zia, or shall we fight it out?
No, you can go to her. That's fine.
All right, so Zia
I
has...
play these games to have fun.
Zia, yeah, you're
happy. So... He doesn't care.
All right, so now here's what happened. Now we all switch to our four-panel page.
Yes.
And we must continue our story. We must continue to include our three theme cards. But now, as a more established mangaka, we have more responsibilities. So we must do four panels. But furthermore, now we have a trend card. And trend cards represent different ways to get fame. For instance, based on what is popular, you will have the opportunity to sell out for what is popular. For instance, science fiction. Ooh, blah, blah, blah. Oh. Science fiction could be popular. Or perhaps a villain could be popular. Or perhaps shoujo manga. And each of these will give us different victory conditions. So, Gia, sorry, Heather, sorry.
Well, either way, Zia, Heather, whatever. It all
okay.
works.
Okay, you have your blue cards that came with your set of mangaka.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so draw two, and then you get to pick which one will be our trend for next round.
Ooh, I get to pick it? Okay.
You indeed.
All right. I don't have to read them both out loud either, right?
No, entirely up to you.
Better pick a good one.
Or else we're going to come and get you.
I don't want to be trending downwards, okay? I want to be trending upwards. I eat those sales! Greed! Greed sells!
Greed sells!
You know, last night, while she's picking, last night when my wife and I were playing again, the last trend package included, like, love and a maid uniform. And they used to say, my wife's like, all right, I'm done. I gotta
Just so you know, this is the one game like that I think that my wife and I could justify buying. I've seen in years that like a board, like an actual game like this because she likes to draw. And I like to be creative, so it would actually work out.
All right, Heather, what do you got?
You guys ready? Okay. Surprise ending.
Yay. All right.
And the animation's very cute, by the way.
So surprise ending.
Okay.
What does this say? So what do we have to... Does it have any flavor text on the card? All
right. Oh, there's flavor text.
Give me flavor text. I want the flavor. I want the flavor.
Each player draws two theme cards and keeps them secret from the other players.
Well, that's going to be hard for me.
A little tricky.
Just that's put it up to the camera and I won't say anything. It's pretty easy, actually.
Okay.
Players reveal their cards at the end of the drawing comics phase. Gain 2 fame for each secret theme you include only in the last panel. If you include the secret themes before the last panel, you spoil the surprise and receive no fame for this trend.
All right, so we got to pick... We pick 2 theme cards.
Uh-huh, and don't tell us what they are.
And we got to keep them secret, and we got to reveal them in the last panel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and show them to each other at the end of the round, so we know what we got. But I guess, Ray, since you don't have a copy of cards, you don't have a set of cards, maybe you should just, why don't you just write down 2 things, and you get them, actually, you get the awesome freedom of choosing those 2 themes.
Ooh.
Okay. Just,
yeah. That seems
That's
like,
fun. Okay.
Wait, so wait, I'm not picking for Ray?
I guess you could, but then, I don't know, unless you can reveal them to him.
Can you hold them up to the, whoever's watching this will just know what I have, so I mean, it's not going to ruin it for him, I don't think.
All right, so I'll tell you what, I'm going to change the screen to Heather there, and I'm going to hold them up to the camera, Ray. All right, I'm not looking, so no one else look, and then...
Okay, got it.
And...
Got it.
I wasn't looking.
All right.
I may have seen one of them. Can you give him another one?
No.
No. Fine.
You're a terrible person.
All right.
All right. Jason sits down.
Okay, we're good to go?
Oh, hold on. Now I need to find my pen. I put my pen down somewhere. All right. Crud. All right.
Ready to start the timer?
5 minutes on the clock, gentlemen. And go.
All right.
It's really quiet now.
Well,
everyone's so focused.
I'm trying to draw a sword, damn it, with a lens flare.
Listen for the sound of sweat dripping off our foreheads.
Oh my goodness, it's only 5 minutes. It's like 1 minute per panel.
3 minutes. 3 minutes and 50 seconds. Sorry.
Hey, great.
Panic.
Oh my god. There's so much pressure.
Oh, crap. I forgot about the secret. Shit.
Add it in. Got time.
1 minute.
Oh my goodness.
Huh.
Oh crap, okay.
My goodness, there's things and happenings and
okay.
Right.
Drop a pen. Mine is kind of awful.
Okay, all right. Let's all do our best.
We do our best.
All right. So we're gonna do the same. We're gonna go around the world here. We're gonna start with Ray.
Start with me because my hand cramped up and I can't write anymore. So I got this far.
Oh no. Okay.
I make pizzas for a living, so I have problems. The doctor has something in his hand and he's using it on the dead bodies that fell on the road. The nurse is chasing after him, and that's as far as I got. It's a close up of the doctor using the amulet that he was using.
Oh, he's using an amulet. I thought that was a pizza. I thought he was holding a pizza, a little mini personal pizza.
I was thinking about it, but no.
Your secret cards.
Yeah.
I didn't even get there. I couldn't get to it.
Okay, where were they?
Oh, cross-dressing and funny faces. I don't even know how I would have gotten there, but...
I thought maybe your secret card was like secret pizza amulets or something.
That'd be awesome.
That would have been awesome.
Secret pizza amulet, he gets points, though.
I don't care about the points.
He gets basic points, like from last round. So, your three themes were doctors, greed, and what was the last one?
Religion.
All right. Well, you got a doctor, so that's 1 point.
The amulet was my attempt at religion, because it was going to mean something, but I haven't gotten there yet.
All right. So what do you think? Does the amulet count as religion, everybody? What do you think?
No, it doesn't yet.
All right. If you, the creator, say it doesn't, then I guess we'll respect your wishes.
I was going to have to draw this much.
It's a drawing game. What do you mean?
I take that back. I didn't think I was going to have to spend a week making pizzas and then draw, okay? Something I don't do normally.
I feel like you're just being a whiny bitch.
Yes.
Whoa!
Calling me out.
The rest can be text.
All right, so how many points does Ray get?
Well, he drew something in each panel, so that's two.
No, yeah. I drew something in two of the four panels. The other two are blank.
Oh, crap, that's right.
Yeah, okay. That's why, I just couldn't get that far.
But you didn't have too many word balloons, so that's two.
There is no word balloons.
Yeah. And you have doctors, so that's 1 point. So I guess three more points.
Yeah, you got three for this round.
So I'm at 10 altogether?
Yes.
Ray.
Yeah.
Good job, Ray.
I'm going to check with the little tokens, because otherwise I'd forget.
All right. Who's next, humanoids?
Heather.
I think I was next last time. Okay.
You are next.
So mine kind of, yeah. All right, let me zoom in here, and I'll explain it. So, continuation of the taming of the stomach. So he's saying, he's up here, we're going to kind of flash back, and he's saying to eat, to what he was saying last time. And the audience is like, boo, hiss, because it sucks. And they're like, I'm leaving, this guy, just awful. And he's crying. And he says, they just don't understand.
It's a lot of word balloons, sir.
And then this guy here is like, I'd rather read about Ichigo. And he says, hoodlums. So I guess my secrets were manga and or comics and juvenile delinquents.
Oh, totally. Yeah.
And I messed up because I was having them throw sweets at him, like treats. But then I was like, oh, crap, I'm going to give away that they're delinquents. And so I had to erase it. And then, anyway.
That was tricky. So is there no cake or pie?
No cake. I will admit there is no cake.
Oh.
He should have been binge eating cake in this one, like, to feel better.
You also have four word balloons.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
All right, but let's look on the bright side. So you've got filled, all the panels filled. That's 2 points.
Okay.
And I believe you have all your themes. You got, or do you not have sweets?
I'm missing sweets.
Okay, so you got 2 out of 3 themes. That's another 2 points. And you have all of your surprise stuff. So that's another 4 points. So you have eight.
So how many total points? 8?
Total points from this round?
Yeah.
8.
8.
Plus
eight.
Last eight. Round, it's
7. So you have 15 total now.
Nice.
All right.
Yes.
All right, Jason.
All right, here's mine. Okay, Babel Burger, Chapter 2. All right, so. Swearing. Why can't my ancient Babylonian restaurant get more customers?
Can you lift it a bit?
Oh, sorry, yeah. Hold on.
It's okay. Oh, there it is. Oh, it's so good.
Okay, swearing. Why can't my ancient Babylonian restaurant get more customers? I need a draw, quote unquote, to make the books add up. $100,000 minus $98,000. He's thinking, right? Okay, waitresses in cute Babylonian costumes. What a brilliant idea! This should work. But then, something happens. Boom! I am become Ereshkigal, Babylonian goddess of death and nuclear weapons. All right, so my secret themes were, my surprise ending was nuclear physics and also magical girls. So I'm not sure if the magical girls count, because she doesn't have like a little, you can't clearly see she has a little skirt or something. I tried to draw a scepter in there, like Sailor Moon style, but it's really up to you guys.
I would give that to you.
I think it counts. Yeah.
Yay, all right. Okay, so in that case, so that's 4. And my themes are food,
right,
archaeology, and mathematics.
We had the mathematics.
And you had the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
So, which now you've blown up, so I'm very curious how you're going to continue with the food theme now.
Yeah.
Well, I'll take myself out of the hole later. All right. Okay, and I think I only have 3 word balloons. I think I filled all the panels, so.
All right, so how many total points is that?
It's 7 for the original stuff, plus 4 for the new stuff.
So 11?
Oh.
11 right. Points.
We're getting killed, guys.
He's the creator. Look, if you didn't expect him to win this, then I don't know what you got. All right.
No, you can team up to defeat me. Do your best.
All right. All right, here we go. All right, so the next phase of Armageddon out of here. All right.
The name just makes me weak. I love it.
So you got the guy with his sword and his gun. He's chopping off his mutant zombie's head. And then he's yelling, die, zombies, as he's shooting his gun at another one. And then over here, he's doing like a little whirlwind thing, and you see a whole bunch of a pile of dead zombies.
Nice.
And then he says, I'll out fox you, zombie fox thing, and that is a zombie wearing a fox costume.
Okay.
So, and my themes were either animal costumes, furries, or cat girls. So, hey, furries can turn into zombies too, alright? Just because they're wearing costumes, don't...
That's fine. I'm just laughing because it's a funny card.
And bad puns are funny names, which is why I'll out fox you. Hence the fox zombie.
Very creative.
So, That's what I that's what I had.
Seems legit.
I think he got it all, actually. How many bubbles did you have?
Die Zombies and the Owl Foxes. I only used two.
Yeah.
Alright, 11 points.
Oof.
Alright.
You guys are neck and neck.
Oh my gosh, we are. So, and now, so now it's time for the next round, y'all. And the next round, we have 6 panels.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
The saga continues. Hold on, I gotta draw my panels here.
All right, furthermore, now we have, we will have two themes, two trends at the same time. And these trends will be chosen by the person with the least fame, which I believe now would be Ray.
Oh, yeah.
But since he doesn't have the trend cards...
Now, yeah. I have a question. So the two secret themes that we had carry over.
No, they actually go away.
Okay.
So now surprise endings are passé. The readers are tired of them, so it's time for a new trend. So.
All right.
And Ray, since you don't have any cards, I guess...
defaults to... defaults to Zia. All right. So she's going to pick.
So I pick two, and then... So do I draw? Right. I can't remember. You draw...
Draw three, and then I guess show them to Ray for him to pick which ones he likes, the two out of those three.
Okay. Ooh, this one could be really tricky. Should I read them out loud and let you pick?
Yeah, show them off, I guess.
Okay, so the first one is gain 5 fame if you're the first person to finish drawing.
Yeah.
Ray's going to discard that one.
So that I can get points.
This one might be kind of difficult to do.
Why you keep picking bad cards?
It's not that. They're tricky. They're tricky, guys. Okay. Fickle trend.
Oh.
Draw one theme card and place it next to this card. The first player to finish drawing who includes this theme gains 7 fame. The second player to finish drawing who includes this theme gains 3 fame. If you include this theme but don't finish first or second, or if you include this theme but draw until time runs out, you lose 2 fame.
Holy cow!
That's nasty. Yeah. Alright? And then the last one. Oh, it's the same card. So, wait, I can redraw, right?
Yeah, redraw.
I had 2 fickle trends. Okay. Celebrity endorsement. I like the card for this one. It's funny. Alright. Write a quote from a real or made-up celebrity praising your comic. The quote counts as a word balloon. Gain 2 fame for each of your obsessions that's related to the celebrity. So, for example, a soccer player, if one of your obsessions is soccer. Gain an extra 3 fame if the celebrity is a real person. Sorry, I'm thinking if we go this route.
Yeah. Well, it's up to Ray to choose.
Well, that definitely the second one. The one that you just said.
Okay.
The celebrity one? Yeah.
The celebrity endorsement?
Yeah. Okay. Right. Oh, yeah.
That one made me start laughing like before I even finished it. So.
Pretty endorsement. And so it's either eager. The other one is either eager fans, which is just a straight up, the first person to finish drawing gets 5. And the or fickle trend, which basically you have to finish drawing and include the secret theme.
Oh, okay. So then the first one.
Okay. So, eager fans.
So seeker. Wait. Oh, wait, so...
Wait, I'm confused. What?
So you want the one where you get points for finishing drawing first without any extra stuff added on, right?
Oh, I meant celebrity endorsement's the one we're doing.
Oh, yeah, but we pick 2.
Oh, okay.
Gosh, I forgot. Ooh!
Because now the market becomes more complicated. There's more subcultures to go after. There's more stuff popular.
So eager fans or the draw one theme card, keep next to it. I will say eager fans would probably be a whole lot easier to pull off.
Eager fans is a simpler card.
Yeah.
Fickle trend, you're basically gonna have to. They're both actually similar cards, but fickle trend, you're gonna have to be betting whether or not you are gonna be the first to finish with that theme.
Then fickle trend.
Wow, so you want to do the harder one?
Sure.
Alright. Wow. Draw a theme card to go with it.
Alright.
Well, I'm screwed. Alright, so fickle trend. A theme going next to this one. is nosebleeds, a common trope in comedy, manga, and anime.
All right, so here's how it's
nosebleeds.
So the first player to finish drawing who has a nosebleed in their comic or a nosebleed theme gets 7 massive points. Second player to include a nosebleed gets 3 points. If you include nosebleeds but you aren't first or second, you lose points. So if you're going to have nosebleeds, you've got to be fast.
So wait, and you have to finish all the panels. All the panels.
No, you can just announce. You don't have to finish all the panels. You can just announce you're done.
Oh. Yeah. So wait, if so you just announce you're done just drawing the nosebleed, or like once you say you're done, you have to stop drawing?
You have to stop drawing, whatever, but I mean, it's up to you what is done, right? I mean, it just means you can't go back to your comic. Mm. You can leave it in whatever crappy state you want, as long as it has nosebleeds, and it'll count for that trend.
Hmm.
But if all of us include nosebleeds, then the last 2 people to draw will suffer a penalty because the public will have turned against nosebleeds by then. Nosebleeds will be out. Out of fashion.
But what if we don't do nosebleeds?
Then it's a straight up nothing. No penalty, no bonus.
Okay.
Whew.
Oof.
Oh, that's gosh. This probably is tough.
Gotta be a betting man there. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So we gotta do either nosebleeds if you're fast, or don't do nosebleeds if you're not. And then the other one that we had to do was
celebrity endorsement.
Celebrity endorsement. All right.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. Well. All
right.
Okay.
I'm ready. How about you guys?
I'm not getting any readier. All right.
Yep. 1, 2, 3, button.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
What? How much time do we have left?
Oh, that's a good point. 1 minute and 46 seconds. It's so funny how after the first round you become so absorbed in what you're doing.
Okay, two panels left.
I'm done.
Okay.
I'm done.
Oh.
Whew. Man.
Oof. Then there's a timer.
Oh my goodness.
Did you finish?
Whew.
All right, Heather, you finished early. Did anyone else finish early?
Yes, I called done second.
Oh, okay.
Done.
All right. Well, let's begin reading with Ray.
I'd rather not, but I'll try.
It'll be good.
I doubt it.
All right, Holy Hemophiliacs, Chapter 3.
Yes, this is one of those times where the person that runs the show or manga here isn't there, and they have to fill in people. So they got a celebrity endorser, and that person is Hellboy, and he says, "I'm Hellboy, and I hate nosebleeds." Okay.
Okay.
So then the next one, it says, "And I'm the I'm the author." Fushnaka Shujinko, because I forgot what his name was already, and since I love Ron Perlman so much, I won't put a nosebleed in the last panel. I think I said that. Yes. Something like that. And it says, also, that's when my hand started to cramp up and hurt. So it said, I switched my left hand and said, I'm also not ambidextrous. I forgot how to spell it. So,
Or I love me some cheese? Does it say I love me some cheese?
No, it says I love me some Theondon, because I'm about to give a shout out to Theo. And then, there's Lucio. Because he plays Lucio.
You've completely given up on the theme.
Panel when it was like a minute left, and I just, I can't use my hands. I can't do it.
No, it's funnier, actually, because you're just...
Did you use your left hand for the last two panels?
Yes.
Wow, you're actually really good at that.
Well, it's because I broke my writing hand right before finals in college, and I had to do everything left-handed.
Wow.
That's awesome. I can't even do any... I can't, no.
Well, okay. So, you have a celebrity endorsement.
Yes, I forgot. Ah, damn it. All right, Lucio counts as, like, greed, right? Because he's green, right? Like,
envy? Like, envy?
No.
I don't know. I'm trying, but I don't think I'm going to get any points.
I don't think that counts as greed.
You're going to get points.
I mean,
okay, so first off, your themes. So there's greed, doctors, and religion.
So there was none of that.
You've officially jumped the shark in your Holy Hemophiliac.
I think jumping the shark is a little bit different than not following the format serve.
Okay, but you only have three word balloons, so you get 2 points for that.
True. I didn't have time to put a fourth in.
That's right. Does Lucio count as greed?
No.
Right, you got 2 points. Did you finish first or second?
No, I was drawing like 5 seconds past when we were supposed to stop.
Well, unfortunately, since you included notably, you lose 2 points.
So you got it.
I said I wasn't going to include nosebleeds. That was the point.
But you wrote nosebleeds.
It's breaking down the fourth wall like Deadpool, okay?
This is like don't think of an elephant. It's hard, you know. I don't know. What do you guys think?
I feel bad for him. I'd give him two.
No, I don't deserve it. I was just messing around.
No, you get points. No, it was funny.
All right, I'll take 20 then.
So it doesn't include nosebleeds. It's saying it doesn't include nosebleeds. So that's good.
All right.
So 2 points. And then you also get a celebrity endorsement. Mm-hmm. I guess Hellboy isn't a real person, but he does relate to hell, which relates to religion. So you get 2 points for that.
See, I was just going with the whole Ron Perlman bit that
so...
over 5 years.
That's good. Okay,
so how many points does he get now? I'm so confused.
Three?
Alright. Three.
Okay.
Alright, Heather. What,
Heather, are you ready?
Show us what you got.
I'm bringing it this round. Okay. So we have... it still says round two. It's definitely... Let me just add a little nubbin. That's round three. Alright. Okay. So our actor is binge eating munch sob on his cake.
Alright, so you got cake.
He's walking along. What?
Well, I'm just counting. It's one of your themes. You had cake.
And he has a weird hairstyle.
And it's weird hair, so
and
you got
weird
two.
Hairstyle. So he says munch sob. He's walking along and he sees a cafe and it's Cafe Yum. And he sees it and he says, "Perhaps I shall take on the role of waiter." And he's looking, and there's a line. He's like, "What is this line about?" He has little question marks. And he sees he's got Google eyes. Oh my gosh, who could it be? I'm Guy Fieri! And I love this pie! And he's like, swoon! And he gets a nosebleed.
All right, so you have a nosebleed, and you were the first to finish, so you get 7 points.
So, wait, what was your third theme?
Theater or acting, weird hairstyles, and desserts.
So does having Guy Fieri count as theater?
No, it counts as celebrity endorsement.
I know, but I'm just saying, I'm trying to figure out where theater is.
Well, I guess the closest I got was, I shall take on the role of waiter, but if that doesn't count, it doesn't count. But
I think Guy Fieri counts as desserts or sweets, though, right?
But he's also an actor. Well, not an actor, but he's a celebrity.
He's a celebrity, yeah. I mean, he's munching on his cake, and there's pie here. It smells good.
She gets the celebrity endorsement, Guy Fieri. I'm just trying to figure out whether Guy Fieri counts as like theater because he's on TV, or if she says the role of waiter counts as theater. I don't know, Jason. You're the creator.
Oh my gosh! Oh, this is a tough one. What does Ray think?
Ray. I'm not a good judge of these things.
It's okay if it doesn't count.
I would say that. I don't think Guy Fieri is an actor, but he does make sweets sometimes or desserts. So I would say that you get 3 points for a celebrity endorsement of a real person, plus 2 points because it relates to sweets. So that means that's 5 points from that. That's 7 points from the nosebleeds.
Damn.
Then you've got 2 points for the weird hairstyles and the desserts.
Yep.
And how many word balloons do you have?
One, two, because those are sound effects. He's munching, he's sobbing, he swoons. That could count, I guess.
I need, before you finish counting up, in the fifth panel there, who's the dude on the, who's is that Guy Fieri right there? Because his legs kind of look like it's just like a nutsack there. I'm just going to throw that out there. All right, what's your score?
All right. I think you get 18 points. You have everything. You have everything except having the theater and acting, and that's 6 points for the original plus 12 points for the other stuff. So I would say you get 18 whopping points.
Wow! Wow!
Bitches!
Wow! 18 for drawing Guy Fieri's nutsack there. Good job.
Well, I've never seen his legs, so who knows?
I've never seen him either. On his TV shows, it's always like from the waist up when he's like eating people's food. Just being like, oh, I'll have a little bit of that, and just sticks his finger.
I mean, you've heard of Dip Buck? She drew guy nuts. Or guy sack. Guy sack. All right, Jason, you are up.
All right, this is Babel Burger, Chapter 3. So, okay. I go away to buy more plate, and I come back to find my ancient Babylonian restaurant reduced to a smoldering nuclear ruin. Ugh. Boss, the curse of Ereshkigal, the curse of Ereshkigal transformed one of the waitresses into a Babylonian deity. Into a Babylonian death god. I calculated there was a 0.0005% chance of this happening.
Okay, there's math. That was math.
And then meanwhile, we see the Babylonian death god going, zap, zap. This manga is the best. Anthony Bourdain, famous chef.
Looks angry. Is he an angry dude?
I couldn't figure out how to draw Anthony Bourdain's figure. He's not like that. He's a little angry, I think.
I think he is, yeah. It almost seems criminal that your work of art there, is good. Yeah.
Well, just, nonetheless, I did not include any nosebleeds, so I get no nosebleed points.
All right.
No.
But the question is, do I have a celebrity endorsement?
You do.
Eh? Okay.
And it's related to your obsessions.
Food or cooking.
Yep.
I was trying to think of something a celebrity that somehow involved food, cooking, math, and archaeology, but I couldn't come up with one. So, but that's 5 points, and I get five. I get I don't know. Do you guys? Did I have my themes? Did I have archaeology?
Yes.
Did I have food?
Yes.
And math?
Yes. Yes.
All right. Well, then I guess that's 7 points for that, plus 5 points for the celebrity, and I get 12 points.
12
now,
points.
Now, do you lose? Because you didn't do nosebleeds?
No, he gets zero.
Because you didn't do a nosebleed.
Yeah.
Nope.
Smart thinking.
I did not lose. I didn't dare. I did not dare to risk it on nosebleeds.
All right. Here we go. Armageddon out of here.
Goes back. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm skipping ahead here. Sorry.
All right. Armageddon out of here. Chapter 3. All right. So. Let's see. Where am I starting? Oh, yeah. All right. So. I need to have some direction here. So he's like, I need to get to the tower to rescue my girl. So there's a little nuclear explosion going on in the background. He's trying to get there. So he stabs a zombie. He's holding his gun. And then he's running. And he's shooting his gun, holding his sword. And he's holding up his sword. And he's running. And there's a shadowy figure blocking the path. And I said... But there's a shadowy figure blocking the path. And that shadowy figure was none other than Mr. T, who says, I pity the fool who tries to get into my tower. Now, I'm not quite sure if that's a celebrity endorsement, but there is a celebrity, and he's a real person, and he's in my comic.
All right, is he guarding the Dark Tower?
Well, I mean, he's guarding the building, and it's kind of like a tower.
All right, so because you said towers, I'd give you points if you include the Dark Tower.
It looks like a pickle. Like a long pickle.
That's his mohawk.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, the tower. But that's a mohawk.
I want to see.
It's a building with windows.
Yeah. It looks like a pickle. It's awesome. No, but the way you drew him, I like the angle that you drew him.
Your comic is like an incredible 80s arcade game.
It really is.
Oh, Streets of Rage.
No, I haven't picked up any pipes yet. All right, so...
I think that counts as a celebrity endorsement. I mean, Mr. T obviously endorses this manga by appearing in it, right? Otherwise, he wouldn't have agreed to be in it.
Yeah, he doesn't... Yeah.
He pities the fool.
It's all about keeping that gold chain.
Yeah.
But does he relate to disasters, guns, or swords?
He's badass.
He's badass. I kind of feel like he does, in a way, but, not...
He doesn't use any of those because he just would punch people instead, or throw them, or just call them a fool and pity them.
He pities them.
He does show up when there's a disaster, but...
Well, there's a nuclear explosion over here.
But yeah, but does Mr. T relate to disasters?
Did he come in a drag, like one of those like Saiyan ships and crash down and cause that blast?
All you know is that there's a nuclear explosion by the tower, there's a shadowy figure, and now, look, boom, there he is.
Great. He hates anime, so the answer
I don't know.
It's probably true. Okay.
Not hates anime, but you know what I mean.
No, I know. He
doesn't appreciate it the same way that we do. We three do.
Well, Dave, I think you definitely get 3 points for Mr. T.
Oh, by the way, and there's a nosebleed going on right here.
Oh, well, that's important. That's very important. So
yes.
So then you get another. You finished second, right?
See, look, he got a little blood on his shirt.
Mm-hmm. He did.
So that's another 3 points for the nosebleeds. That's 6. And I think you got all of your stuff. So I would say you get 13 points.
Yay!
Boo!
Boo, man. Yes.
Sorry. I have to take attention off myself.
How much fame does everybody have going into the final round?
Well, let's see. Ray has 13.
Okay.
Thank you.
Let's see. Heather has 33.
I have 30.
Yep, you have 30. And I have...
Spend my title here. Not title, I don't have a title yet.
I have 31.
So, all right.
So Heather's Ray's in the lead.
So Ray continues his role of picking the trends. And now in the final round, not only do we have 8 panels, but we have 4 trends. And Ray must choose 4 out of 5 trends.
Oh, man, that's a lot.
That's right.
Trendmaster. That's what I am.
I'm going to put final round.
Okay.
Final round.
Final round.
Finish him.
Tradition. So who would win in a fight out of all of our celebrity endorsements? Hellboy, Mr. T, Anthony Bourdain, or Guy Fieri?
Ooh, Hellboy.
Yeah.
No.
I knew it, Sarah. If you're going to try to defend your bullshit, you're not going to get points.
No. No, I'm sorry, but Guy Fieri floating on his magical nutsack wins.
Okay, well, Bourdain is definitely out. I'm going to concede.
I don't know, Bourdain looked pretty mad.
He looked mad, but he was a floating head, and I still think Heather's Guy Fieri on his magical floating nutsack wins the day.
I just realized that my little Hellboy kind of looks like Earthworm Jim or something. Like, I was trying to draw like the things on top Jim, of his like, head or whatever, but...
Had his head cut off, yeah. I had a weird obsession with Earthworm Jim for like all my... Young, I just thought he was like the coolest character ever. I'll take it.
We may have to get into your obsession with Earthworm Jim. And...
Earthworm Jim? Oh my gosh, yeah. Well, he's awesome. Alright, anyway.
Alright, so Ray has to pick some trend cards.
So basically, okay. Yeah, draw 5 and you pick, you choose to discard 1 of the 5.
Alright.
What do we got? What do we got?
5. Okay. What do we got? Ray Fist. Trends. Right. First trend, continuity. Name a previously unnamed character for 2 fame. In addition, gain 1 extra fame for each character you refer to by name who was already named in a previous round. Who? Okay.
I haven't named anybody. Right.
Subtlety. Players are not allowed to express themes by using any of the words in the title or description of the theme card, or any direct variants, such as sacrificed for sacrifices. Any player who breaks this rule loses 4 fame for each theme so expressed. So just to clarify, that means players are not allowed to express themes by using any of the words in the title. So I couldn't say, oh, I'm going to be a famous actor.
Yeah.
Or like... I'm gonna go eat the sweet treats. Or like, yeah. I'm gonna go eat dessert. Okay.
You should show them scarfing their face.
Yes.
Okay, got it. Simplicity. Gain 3 fame if no words in your comic are more than 5 letters long. Or if you don't use any words at all. Oh, that one's hard. Okay. Melodrama. Write at least 1 word balloon consisting entirely of someone shouting another character's name. Maximum 1 word for 3 fame.
Mm-hmm. right. Sorry. Well,
it's I'm like entertained by this one. Sorry, I didn't mean to. Oh, go ahead.
No, show it.
Yeah, no, the art is cool. And the art is cool on all of these cards. It's beautiful.
Like, that's verbosity.
Yeah, so verbosity. Gain 2 fame for each word balloon with 10 or more words. I like that one.
Okay, so what are our 5 choices? Or what
oh
are
my goodness. Right, what can are we going for?
The subtlety?
You want to get rid of one?
Or you I'm trying to remember what it was.
It's people. You're basically not allowed to write your theme in letters. Like, you can't put...
All right, so drop that one.
Oh, okay. So then we have continuity. Name a previously unnamed character for 2 fame. In addition, gain 1 extra fame for each character you refer to by name who was already named in a previous round. Simplicity. 3 here... If no words in your comic are more than 5 letters long. Or if you don't use any words. Up against verbosity, which is encouraging you to use at least 10 words in your word balloon.
But if they're all short, if they're all having like 5 or less letters, then you can win both the points for verbosity and simplicity.
That's tricky. And then melodrama. Write at least 1 word balloon consisting entirely of someone shouting another character's name.
Wow. Okay.
Holy tomatoes.
This is where the chaos begins.
The big one. This is the big one, guys. 5 minutes on the clock.
Okay, and there's no subtlety. It's just going to be for... There's no subtlety, of course. There's going to be verbosity, simplicity, melodrama, and... what was the other one? Continuity. Okay, I'm going to hold these up on my end with my left hand so you can see what... So anyone who forgets what they are can see them on my screen. Melodrama. Verbosity. All right. All right. Here we go. Okay. All right. Well, folks, I'm ready when you are.
Wow. That is a lot.
All right. I guess it's time to jump into the pool. Let's do it.
All right.
1, 2, 3, go. Pressure's on, guys.
No kidding.
Well, I gotta draw them with nuts, like a floating nutsack.
No one was going to be able to beat that. I mean, that's just fantastic.
What is it again? More than 5 letters long. Thank you. commands.
Oh my goodness.
Oh gosh, 15 seconds.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah, I did not finish.
Okay, yeah, you did fine.
Oh gosh.
Oh my goodness.
Alright, well.
I wasn't zoomed in that whole time. Oh my gosh, like the silence. It was killing me.
Oh my goodness, I'm telling you.
No wonder you wanted music. Holy cannoli.
Holy cow, it's getting warm. Alright.
I'll speak lyrics aloud. Hearts on fire.
Ray, you have done the honors every time. All right, so you go first. So.
Alright, Ray, how does Holy Hemophiliacs end?
Yes. Well, I couldn't really think of a good way to end it, so I just started a new one again. So there's Zenyatta
from Overwatch. He's like drawn really fun.
It's like a, it looks like a potion.
Anyways, he just imagine him popping into just somewhere into existence because he was the god from this story.
Okay.
He popped into a girl in the shower and she yells at him, and he gets a nosebleed. Right there, and then says,
"Doesn't count anymore."
Then he pieces out. He said, "Sorry," and she's still in the shower. There's the evil doctor with his amulet still in another time space.
Is that an octopus?
Zenyatta shows. Listen, I had to go left-handed at some point.
Yeah.
Zenyatta's turned into a squid.
Zenyatta said, "That's my ball," because it's one of his balls, and then he starts glowing and he's yelling no while he's disintegrating away. He's disintegrating away more. and then he said 5 seconds, so I just wrote Zenyatta.
Zenyatta go.
That's all I had left. So, okay. Zenyatta was my link to religion because he's all Zen.
He's also a previously unnamed character, right?
That's okay, yeah. True. That's true. Yeah.
I didn't even think about that.
There we go. 2 points.
The doctor was still there, but I mean, I took him out. I don't know if that counts. Or I guess it's implied that I took him out. You don't know.
What do you guys think? Is the doctor still there?
I'll give it to him.
The evil doctor with his amulet.
Yeah, he was there up to no good. I think Creeper was more than 5 letters, so I didn't get that. So was Zenyatta. I think I had like 6 different lines in there. So I lost. I didn't get anything on that. I mean, the doctor was still being greedy, but that's. I feel like that's just a constant thing with him being there. So that's cheating.
No. Okay. Well. No. I mean, it's up to you guys.
He had his ball.
That's true. He was stealing people's ball.
He stole somebody's ball.
What does Guy Fieri's nutsack say?
It counts.
All right, okay. It counts.
He gave it a roundhouse kick and a yeehaw.
So he gets all his themes. That's 3 points. He's got a new character. That's 2 points. I think you used too many balloons, so you don't get points for that. I don't know. I don't think you filled all the panels.
I did. I mean, the last one was just text because it was 5 seconds left, but it just says Zenyatta, yo.
That text. It doesn't count as being filled. It
doesn't count.
Oh.
Okay, whatever. Okay. It's not like I'm going to win anyways. So.
Could have been the greatest comeback ever.
No, do you have any long word balloons that are like 10 words?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And do you have any large sound? Do you have a melodramatic name shouting?
Unless the doctor's name is No. Oh, it's it was a tie-in to the Doctor No.
James Bond movie. No, yeah. Same thing here.
No, I didn't. I don't think I used. I think I used that.
Oh. Well, it could be the doctor's name.
I know, but.
All right. So
when I do actually write this, I want to make sure I don't write myself into a hole.
All right. So 3 points plus 2 points. That's 5 points.
Yes.
Well done, Ray.
Success.
Right.
All right, Heather. It's your turn.
Okay, I didn't finish.
All
right. So I continued the nutsack theme, but it sometimes disappears. So I apologize. So he yells. Fieri! He's like, oh my gosh, and he drops his pie that he's eating, crash. And he's on his knees, he's falling down, and Fieri's like, what's with this guy? Question. And he says, the actor, remember their actor, he says, I am Bob. You are so wow. I went to act, but I want to cook. And Fieri says, come with me. He's like, where are we going? And he's like taking him to the pot in the kitchen. And the way it was going to end was...
He threw a giant black dildo.
What?
That's what it looks like!
Where?
Right there!
That's exactly what it is. No, they were going to... he's going to like fulfill his dream to be a cook and because he loves pie and things like that instead of acting.
So what is he throwing?
Well, that's because we ran out of time. He was going to be holding a pot.
Oh!
Here's your part.
Oh, I thought he was throwing something.
Together. Yeah, he was in a train under Guy Fieri.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Ugh. Well, I like where this is going. Okay, so I think you've got all your themes. You've got sweets, or you've got weird hair, and you've got acting, which you talk about.
Yeah.
I don't think you don't need to use too many balloons. That's another 2 points. That's 5 so far. You name a previously unnamed character. So that's 2. That's 7. You have a melodrama. So that is 10. And I believe you have simplicity because it's all 5 words or 5 letters or less, right? So that is 13 points.
Yes. Hey, and do I get so verbosity? That was my question.
Oh, yes. Oh, is that more than
2? I am... Bob, you are so wow. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Does that count?
Yes, it
because
does.
Because it's short words? Okay,
cool. Count. So that's 15 points.
Nice.
Excellent.
Wow.
Bring it.
All right, well, here's mine.
All right, Jason is up. What do we got?
Okay. All right, final chapter. Babel Burger. Okay. Why did my desire to make an ancient Babylonian restaurant spell the end of the world? What happened? Why are we being driven from our homes by a magical death goddess shooting rays from above? Why? Hold on, sorry, what's going on? Okay. House burned to the ground. Just as I paid the final payment of $4,300... plus $100 of tax. Meanwhile, die, mortals. Die for culturally appropriating Babylonian food. Zap. Okay. Ereshkigal! I'll send you, seal you in your tomb with a cooking contest. The loser goes back to, the loser returns to the grave. Dun, dun. But then the, I missed my deadline. Into the cliffhanger.
Boss is like, I need this vow.
I know, I'm like...
To be continued.
I'm so busy rolls comics, like every one of them. How's it go? What's gonna happen?
All right, so I guess the question is, do I have archaeology, food, and mathematics for starters?
Babylonian, you have your mathematics. You got your food every time. All right.
But sadly, I have too many balloons, so I don't get points for that, and I don't finish the panel, so I don't get points for that. So that's 3 points so far. I don't know if I count as continuity because I didn't name any previous, unless Ereshkigal counts, but I did mention her before.
You've mentioned Ereshkigal because you did it in the last one.
Yeah, I got 1 point for that. So that's four total.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have here's my true strategy. I have five balloons with 10 or
for more. Each word balloon.
Right.
It's for multiple word balloons.
Oh.
Okay, so so that's 10, so that puts me at 14. I definitely do not get simplicity. but I do have melodrama, I think, if you count Ereshkigal screaming the name.
Right.
And so that gives me 17.
Wow.
Wow.
So
wow.
That's where I'm at. That's where it's at, folks.
All right.
And I guess it's the turn of Dave.
Yeah. Oh, man. All right. So,
all right, let's see it.
Final chapter of Armageddon out of here. All right. So, first of all, he says, damn you, Mr. T. I will end you and your hair. So, he's angry. So, there they are squaring off with an atomic explosion going on in the background. Notice Mr. T's hair there. One notice that he called out Mr. T by name this time. So then Mr. T takes off his necklace and starts using it as a weapon. He pulls out his sword and is making a clanging noise. And Mr. T wraps his necklace around our hero's neck and starts strangling him. But then he breaks free of the chain. And then Mr. T's looking angry. The other guy is looking pretty good. Then he pulls out his gun and says, take that, Mr. T. Now get out of my way.
Dang. All right. Well, really have guns, swords, and apocalypses. And you only have two balloons. So 7 points for all of that good stuff. You actually did all your panels.
You finished yours, yeah.
It was a mad dash at the end here. I knew I drew this before I drew, like, these three.
Okay.
So.
And you get continuity because you refer to Mr. T. So that's eight. How many word balloons have 10 or more words?
Let's see. So this was all. Damn you, Mr. T. I will end you and your hair. So that's one. And then take that, Mr. T. Now get out of my way. So that's two. With 10.
All right. So that's 8 plus 4. So that's 12. You don't have simplicity.
Oh, none of them are longer than five letters, right?
Wait, seriously? Oh. None of the words are longer than five letters?
Nope.
Holy crap. No way.
Wow.
Not a single one.
I think you got that one.
No, every single word is no more than four.
Oh my god, alright, so that's 15 points so far. You get more points for simplicity. Very good. Alright, and do you have a word balloon with a character just shouting another character's name?
No.
Nothing else. Alright, so 15 points. So everybody tally up, and
yes.
All right. We will see who is the winner. Okay.
Let's see.
All right, I know what I counted because I kept track with these guys.
Oh my god, I think it's gonna be close. Right.
Uh-huh.
I know what mine is, but
I know what mine is. I want to know what your alls are.
Okay,
I want to go last.
Okay. I'll go first. I got 47 points.
Okay. I got 46.
Oh, Heather?
48.
Oh, okay.
59.
No.
What?
Ray, you got
it. Was like 16 or something.
18, Ray. Give yourself some credit there.
The winner of the manga countdown is Sir.
Yes, it's everything I dreamed. Oh my gosh, makes me so happy.
Now you may wear this and prove to everyone that you are a champion mangaka.
Wow.
I feel like we should tradition where we try and win it each like year or something and like pass the headband around.
Well, congratulations, you have defeated me.
Well, that's, I thought you were gonna get me there with that two word balloon thing, like the more than whatever, the 2 points for every 10 words. That was clever. No.
But I didn't have any simplicity. I had no simplicity. My words were all long. I failed.
Oh.
It would have taken too long for me to think of short words, and I was just into cranking it out.
Man, all I had to do was write one thing, draw one thing where they were yelling out, like, just Mr. T's name, and I would have...
Mr. T!
Could have just been T! Exclamation point, exclamation.
Oh, I could have had Ice-T show up. I'd throw like lemonade at somebody.
Ice Cube show up?
I could have had Ice Cube show up too.
Oh my gosh, it would have just like kept perpetuating.
Did you have Vanilla Ice?
Oh man, it could have been a whole thing.
Alright, well, and that's that. That's the game. That's a game, folks. So what did you think?
I don't draw enough.
that's the one thing that I need to get a pen in my hand if I'm gonna play this again and work on my muscles in that hand. Holy crap!
Well, it sounds like you've been working really hard. I mean, I'm sorry that you had to play with the equivalent of carpal tunnel or repetitive stress syndrome. That's rough.
It's just been the worst week for it. That's all. I'm normally better.
You know,
I just want to quickly add that. I love the fact that this is a one-player game. I know I talked about this when you first came on the show and we're just launching the Kickstarter. It's so good if you're just having writer's block or you're just trying to be creative in some way or, like, put something down. Because it's a single-player game if you want it to be.
Yeah.
And I really love that about it.
Oh, cool, yeah. I mean, I really enjoy the one-player game. I mean, I've played it one player like 20 or 30 times, and the rules are a little different, but basically it's just a time trial where you're competing against yourself to see how long you can keep the story going with more and more stuff added to it. I enjoy it a lot. It's different than the multiplayer game where there's obviously a competitive element, but it's also more about like keeping track of all the stuff that you can do to get points, you know? So it's kind of like a brain managing all of this stuff that you could possibly do to get points. Strategy is the strategy essentially.
So this game takes me back to like my high school days where my friend and I, we used to make like comic books. Like he was a phenomenal artist, and I was like an average artist, I would say, at the time. But I liked writing a lot more. I liked writing up and coming up with stories. So one of his problems was he could never come up with a story. He could just draw. So I would draw, like, sketch up, like, panels really quick and with a story, and, like, I'd give it to him, and then he would make it, like, really good. So this takes me back to that, and that kind of has that nostalgic element when doing this. So it's fun. I definitely enjoyed it. And
yeah.
And I will say that my wife and I played it a few times now, and I know I brought this up, but I could not stop laughing every time she drew her amputee that wanted to be a comedian who went to a fortune teller. It was ridiculous and awesome. And even tonight's game with the Guy Fieri floating nutsack and Ray being, well, Ray, I mean, it, and
his Zenyatta. He's got to have Zenyatta.
Yeah, the battle bird. Like, it's just so much fun to see everyone's like strange and crazy ideas because of like you have to use like certain ideas. It's cool. I like it.
I'm kind of amazed and impressed we were able to keep it ages 13 and up too.
We did our best.
I dropped a BS there.
You didn't draw a giant. There was a giant nut. Oh. As well.
Okay. Yeah, there wasn't that
stuff. But I didn't mean to. I would have gone away, and but Dave had to take it there.
I did think your person was throwing something that was not age appropriate at one point. But
it was a pot handle. I just couldn't, you know. All right. Well, I guess it could be a pot handle in a weird way.
So
the porn kitchen.
So Jason, let me ask you, for people who are still wanting to maybe pick up Mangaka, is it available at mangakagame.com?
Yeah, it's available actually. Mangakagame.com has info about the game, and it has a link to my website, store.mockman.com, which has the where you can actually buy the game right now. And after Christmas, starting the new year, it'll be carried by Japanime Games. And you'll be able to buy it, or you can pre-order it now to show up in stores. So it'll be available to retailers, and you can also get it from them. And if you order it now, you can get a special expansion pack of cards, which I think you guys already. I sent this to you, so it was
next to your desk. Thank you.
But yes, this includes the maids and butlers card and various other exciting trends and themes which you can add to your game. So. So yeah, it is available now, and it will be in stores in the spring. So please, please check it out and pick it up.
So we gotta ask, since we always pimp out our Amazon, like, will it be available through Amazon at some point?
Yeah, I think I don't know if it's available now, but it will be. It should be available from Amazon, and those are fulfilled by Japanime Games, and so check it out. And it should be there. It'll be wherever awesomer games are sold.
So. Awesome. Look at that. So, look, you can get an awesome game through Amazon eventually by clicking through our link. So you can buy Jason's awesome game and help us out at no additional cost. Look at that.
It's
so managed to work with us.
Yeah, look at that.
So Jason, thank you very much for coming on and playing your game with us.
Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you guys. I'm really happy that you like it. It was super fun playing with you. And, yeah, if you'd ever like to have me on to talk about tabletop stuff or about anime and manga, then let me know. I really appreciate you guys back in the game and supporting it.
Oh, I definitely think that we should definitely be playing some more tabletop with you in the future. This was a lot of fun.
This is a lot of fun, and it was a good. We'd never done anything like this before in terms of having. Doing art or trying, so this was a nice challenge for us as well. So
our first live tabletop.
Yep. Yeah.
Look at that.
It felt like,
you're going down.
Ray. He's talking to you.
Well, Sarah, what I was going to say is I felt like George Lucas just now, and I felt like the technology doesn't exist to get my idea out there, so I'm going to keep remastering these, and I'm going to keep releasing them every couple of months.
I'm going to be honest here, Ray. Your comic was kind of like Geely.
I know.
I thought JLO in there. But, you know, next time you can just play play collaboratively. And, I mean, there's rules for playing, for two people playing in the same team. And then you can just be the idea man. And your, collaborator can...
See, that's great. That is great. Like, I actually like that. Now I can... Oh, my God, me and my wife can be a team.
That's right.
She can draw and I'll give her ideas. This is awesome. I'm going to bring her on next time.
I feel like that's going to end with her slapping you.
She married me. She knows what she's getting into.
All right. Well, thank you, Jason. And,
thank you, Jason.
And this was a lot of fun. We'll definitely do it again.
Thanks, you guys. It's really great of you all to have me on. And, yeah, thanks for being cool.